What's your mind, Sorgan G3 here, and today, it's a different video. Tonight, actually, it's probably gonna go up later at night. But, today we're gonna talk about, Metal Gear Solid, Konami, and Hideo Kojima. Now, controversy arose this year when Kojima was he was, basically fired from Konami. They revoked all his stuff, and, you know, he left just the other day, I believe. Maybe yesterday, even. I think it was yesterday. Holy floof. But, like, he left Konami, and they still have access to, like, Metal Gear and all that, and, you know, now he has to make his own new stuff. He signed a deal with Sony. Today we're gonna talk about the state of Metal Gear. Metal Gear Solid, or Metal Gear in general, about Hideo Kojima. Now, you're gonna see some Metal Gear Solid 3 footage. I would play some more Metal Gear Solid 5, but... see, I don't know. Well, one, I'm trying to play Metal Gear Solid 3 right now. Two, I don't really want to play Metal Gear Solid 5 right now. The mission I'm on sucks. I'll look how to beat that later after I beat 3 and Peace Walker. You know, I'll get there. But anyway, talking about Metal Gear without Kojima. Now, Kojima has no access, I presume, to any of his old stuff, which I guess is just Metal Gear, Zone of the Enders, Snatcher. Have he made some other games too? I don't really know. I just know him for Metal Gear, but... yeah, Konami's a bunch of jerks. They revoked his stuff, and, you know, it's really floofed up. However, Konami hired a whole new team to make new Metal Gear games. It's like, what the floof, dude? It's like, what the floof? You kick this dude out, you're gonna make games without him? Now it's like Metal Gear Solid 6 presumably is being made, or will be made at some point. Yeah, I hear rumor of a movie. Actually, let me look that up really quick. MGS, a movie. Let's look at this. I don't know. I thought there was a movie. There could have been a movie. News. I don't think there's a movie, but whatever. There probably will be. I just got wind from a movie, but that doesn't matter right now. What matters is Kojima. Kojima, Metal Gear Solid. Now they hired a whole team to work on games without him. His baby. His series. Without him. How could they do that? They're a bunch of corporate scumbags, and that's basically it. They're just a bunch of corporate scumbags. So why is this matter? Well, people still... well, I got into an interesting Twitter conversation over the last day or so, and it's about Metal Gear Solid. I was saying, I'm going to unfollow Konami because I have no reason to follow them anymore. And it's like, my boy Jamie... now, this isn't starting to be a hate campaign against him or anything. He's a great guy. But this is just like, I don't understand where he's coming from with this. Basically, what he's saying is that he says, you know what, it's like they're gonna be MGS6 and there's a movie, that's where I got the movie from. And then I was like, no, well there is, presumably, but they're gonna be without Kojima, without a series he made, without him. And he said, whatever man, I'm still gonna play it, it's like, it's a good game, I like it. And that, I understand that. But today I'm gonna talk about what Metal Gear could be like without Kojima. Just games in general that are made without their original creators. Now basically, a lot of games, this happens with a lot of games, you know. Sometimes it could just be a deal with a different developer or publisher, or it could be a deal with someone else, or the IP could just be bought for real. Now, talk about IPs that were bought. I believe Crash Bandicoot was actually purchased by Activision, I think. That was a while back. And where's Crash? Where's Crash? Where's Crash? Where's Crash at? I don't see him. And I don't know where Crash is, to be honest. I really don't know. Where's Crash at? I couldn't tell you. Alright. You know, that's just an example. Crash is basically dead at this point. I don't know what games he's had recently, or at all. Oh. But, let's just talk about like what happens to franchises when they are bought out or their creator leaves, basically. Like Kojima. Spyro. What was Spyro made by? Actually, I don't know this. Spyro original creators. Who made the first Spyro game? Because I don't know this. Because this is very important. Let's see. Insomniac Games made Spyro. Like, the original. Now, basically, you know, that's Spyro. Spyro's a really freaking cool dude. Dragon does stuff. I didn't really grow up with Spyro, but that's not the point, though. The point was, I believe it was in 2011. They made a Spyro, well, not a Spyro game, but a game called Skylanders Spyro's Adventure. That was not like Spyro at all. It was a completely different game with new characters. No one knew these characters. And they just kind of happened. And it was like a collecting thing. You had to collect action figures and put them in your game. It was a money-making scheme, basically. It was genius. But Spyro wasn't the main star. They used Spyro's name to sell the game. It was not a Spyro game at all. Sure, you got the Spyro figurine to use in your game when you bought the game, but it wasn't about Spyro. It wasn't about Spyro at all. And it's... well, Spyro was in it, but he wasn't a main focus. They were using his name to sell a product, basically. Now, what else is there? Let me think for a minute, because I can bring up a lot of points here. So we've talked about... this is like one of those rant-type videos of what can happen when devs leave, IPs are sold or bought out or stuff like that. How about I go the low road here. How about we take Sonic? Oh boy, we're gonna get into some fun territory here. Now, if you don't know, Sega, contracted a studio called Big Red Button to make a game called Sonic Boom Rise of Lyric. Trailer came out early 2014. It was looking like a really good game from that one trailer, you know? They made it look really good. Heck, I think it looked better than the final game. Honestly, it looked better than the final game. Freaking Wii U could do that. It could. However, the game was terrible. Big Red Button made it. It wasn't made by Sonic Team at all. But Big Red Button was made up of people who made Ratchet and Clank, Uncharted, former Naughty Dog developers, who made really good games. What the floof happened? Rushed garbage. And even if it wasn't rushed, it would still be garbage. Because when I played the game, I didn't really encounter many glitches. I encountered some, like the Knuckles glitch. That was the only fun part of the game, and they patched it. You can't do the Knuckles glitch anymore. Basically, when the most fun thing about your game is a glitch, you've royally screwed up. But that just happens. That is one of the worst case scenarios, but you know, we can't really blame them. It was rushed, right? We can blame them. Even if it wasn't rushed, it's still a boring game. The cutscenes are funny, I will admit. It has some good humor. I laughed a lot of times, but it's not a fun game. It's really not. Really not a fun game at all. Where am I going with this? It's like... oh, phone vibrator, shut up. There's a lot of things that can go wrong when an IP is put in someone else's hands. Alright. So Metal Gear in general, was Hideo Kojima's child. I like to call it his child, basically. His child that he nurtured and cared for. He cared for Metal Gear like it was his own freaking child, man. It's crazy. He loved that series and went for like over 25 years, I believe. Made a lot of good games, a lot of good spin-offs. And you know, recently, he was kicked out of Konami. Why is this? I really don't know. I could look it up, but I don't know. I think it's creative differences, but I don't remember. Basically, what is Metal Gear gonna be like without the father of it, Kojima? What is it gonna be like without him? The simple answer is, it's not gonna be the series you love. Look, I get it. Like, you know, you assume it's like, you buy this game, it has a good name on it, you know it's gonna be good. It's like Metal Gear Solid, it's like you can usually assume that. But it's be good because of the people who make it. Kojima made Metal Gear, he's been making Metal Gear for 25 years now, and now he can't. So what's he gonna do now? Gonna make new games? Hopefully. I would love to see a new game by him. But basically, what's going down is that Konami is going to make Metal Gear games without Kojima. And that's rubbing me the wrong way. Because they're not going to be the same quality. You loved Metal Gear Solid before, but now it's not going to be the same. It was his envisionment, and now they're taking it, and they're probably going to ruin it. It could be good. I'm not saying it's going to be bad. It could be good. Think about this. You kicked off the creator, the soul of that series, and his team with it. Kojima Productions disbanded. Well, they're back now, a little bit of them. But they've now disbanded. And now it's a broken home. Konami's a broken home. It's a really bad place. Really bad company, to be honest. And look, you know, it's like, it's Metal Gear, man. How could they floof that up? Well, Spyro. I'm going to bring up the examples I mentioned. Spyro, they floofed it up by using his name to sell a game. Crash? Crash. Wait a minute. Actually, Google, Crash Bandicoot. Now, where's Crash? Where's Crash been? What was the last game he was in? Games? Just in general here. Let's see, last game of the main series that Crash was in, of the main series, and I remember this game, dude, Mind Over Mutant, holy floof. 2008. What was the last game in general? Well, let's see. 2010. The last game, according to Wikipedia right here, the last game was a mobile game called Crash Bandicoot Nitro Kart 2, released in 2010. And Crash, I guess he's just off the map. He was at Naughty Dog, now he's at Activision, he's dead. And what about Sonic, you say? Big Red Button was contracted to make a game, I guess based off the TV show. It could be the other way around, but I wouldn't know about that. Contracted him to make a game about Sonic, and, you know, all they had to do was make him go fast. What are you doing for 90% of the game? Going slow, platforming at a very slow speed, and fighting. Lots of combat. I'm losing my voice. Lots of combat. Harkening back to the days of Sonic Unleashed, a game that not a lot of people liked. I liked it, though. I liked the combat in Sonic Unleashed. But, you know, it's like with Metal Gear. Think about that. Think about it. With Kojima, the father and soul of his series, where are they going to go with the story? Where are they going to go with the gameplay? Is it going to be another Metal Gear Solid 5? If so, it'll do great. But if not, if it's not another Metal Gear Solid 5 quality game, it's done. It's done after that. Like, the games before have been so high budget. I mean, MGS1 on the freaking PlayStation. My favorite, personally. I haven't played them all, and I feel like I'm going to like 3 more than 1. I don't know why. I'm having a feeling I'm going to like 3 more than 1. That's why I'm playing it right now. I'm probably playing that for gameplay. If I'm lazy, I'm just going to be using Metal Gear Solid 1 footage for my LP. Think about this. The soul isn't there anymore. It's an empty shell. It's a cash grab! A cash grab! Do you know what Konami's been doing? They're taking all their freaking franchises and putting them into pachinko machines! What's pachinko? I looked it up. I don't know. What's pachinko? What is that? It's some kind of Japanese gambling game or something, but I wouldn't know about that because I'm not Japanese. That's not the point, though. What they're doing is, it's all cash grab. Like, the Metal Gear Solid name, basically. At this point, if they don't nurture it good, it could become a cash grab. Do you really want the series that you love so much to become that? No. You want it to be good and full of heart, you know, like the other games, you know? About a dude sneaking into bases, destroying giant things? That's basically the plot of, like, every game. But, you know, it's not gonna be the same anymore. It's gonna be different. It's gonna be weird. It could suck. It could suck a lot. It really could suck a lot. And I'm betting the next game, well, could just be a cash grab. Now, the only good direction, honestly, that I can see Metal Gear going is if they let Platinum Games make Metal Gear Rising 2. That is the only way, because it wouldn't be developed by Konami. It'd be by Platinum Games. But then again, I guess it was Kojima's story. It was Kojima's story, and now the story won't make any sense, because Metal Gear Solid is a story-driven series. However you feel about it, it is a story-driven series. And what they're gonna do, like, if it's not story-driven, like, if the story doesn't make sense, then, well, it doesn't make sense already. But if they floof up the story, then what do you have? It was Kojima's. It was his story. It was his game. His Solid Snake. You know, it's just like, they're not gonna make it good. It's not gonna be the same. It's probably gonna suck. Oh boy. It's definitely gonna suck. Like, unless they go a good route on Metal Gear Solid 5, great! But who made Metal Gear Solid 5? Let's think about this. Who made Metal Gear Solid 5? Do you think it was Kojima? Put his heart and soul into that game to complete Metal Gear Solid's story? I think it's complete, at least. There could be, like, another 50 prequels. I think it's complete. I wouldn't know, though, unless they do another game like Metal Gear Rising, which takes place in the future. And, you know, this continue riding story, that is another way. But I can see it working. I can see it working out that way. But, you know, Konami, they need to get their heads on straight. Like, seriously, they're just doing things for cash grabs now. They're done. All they're doing is soccer games, pachinko machines, and Metal Gear. That's it. Without Kojima, Metal Gear. That isn't a Metal Gear I want to play. So the next Metal Gear game that Konami makes, it's not a real Metal Gear. I'm sorry to say, but it's not a real Metal Gear game. It's not. The next game Metal Gear has is not a Metal Gear game. It is a cash grab game. It's not the Metal Gear game that you once knew. It is simply a grab for money because they're going under. Seriously, like, without their franchises now, they canceled Silent Hills, they canceled... fire Kojima, they're changing all their franchises into pachinko machines. They've stopped AAA games. All they're gonna make is soccer games, basically. Like, Konami owns Yu-Gi-Oh! That worries me. Friggin', I'd buy another Yu-Gi-Oh! Game if it wasn't made by Konami! I really would. I had a lot of fun with the one that was on PS4 this year. I thought it was a great game. Got me back into the game. You know, I never really played Yu-Gi-Oh! In real life, but I watched the anime, and I do like the Bridge series, but that's not the point, though. The point is, Konami made Yu-Gi-Oh! I mean, they own it. I mean, I don't know if they made it, but you know. If they don't flip that up, then they still have a little tiny spot in my heart for them. A little tiny, little, I'm talking like ant size, no, freaking atom size hole. There's just a little spot in my heart there, you know? Little, it's tiny. Because they've taken everything I loved about them, and they ruined it. They soiled it. Soiled it, man. They can't do it. My voice is going to go out. That's not a good thing. But, you know, Kojima left. I guess he was fired. I don't know if he left or if he was fired. I probably look that up. But you know what? It's just, screw you, Konami. I'd say the F Konami, but I can't say that. Why would I do that? I'm a good person. Is it okay in this situation? Can I actually say the F word to Konami? I never swear. I would never say that. But whatever, you know, a Metal Gear game without Kojima. What do you guys think about that? Do you think it could work? Are you like me and you think it would suck? It wouldn't be the same game? Because if you are, you're right. It wouldn't be the same game. The father of the series. You know why you love the original Metal Gear games and Metal Gear Solid so much? Kojima made them. He made them what you liked. And now Konami's gonna take them and they're not gonna care. The next one might not even star Solid Snake for all we know. It could be freaking Naked... It couldn't be Naked Snake either. It could be freaking... Snake. It could, like, start an actual snake sneaking around. Was that a Metal Gear game you'd play? Actually, that sounds kind of cool. But that wouldn't be Metal Gear Solid. You were a snake. There's no point in sneaking. Because you're a snake. Where am I going with this? If you're a snake, you don't really need to sneak around from anything. You'd basically be invisible the whole time. That's not the point, though. The point is, Konami's terrible. They kicked out the guy who made the series that everyone loves, including myself. And, yeah, that's it. Konami's a terrible company. That's the gist of this whole video. Metal Gear's done, basically. All the real games are done. The saga is basically done. If they make another Metal Gear game after this, it's not a Metal Gear game. It's not. It's a spinoff. Even if it says Metal Gear's all in the box, you know that's not true. It's a spinoff, because it's... It's not made by Kojima. Even if it's legitimately a spin-off, it's like, it can't be like a Metal Gear game. Because it's not made by the dude who made the series, made by some other sources. It's crazy to think about, and I don't really like it. What do you guys think? If another Metal Gear game gets made, I am either not buying it or I'm pirating it. I don't care. I really don't care. It's Konami. They're the worst company in the world. And, yeah, that's basically it. Thank you for watching this video. Thanks for listening to me rant for almost 20 minutes. Actually, we are at 20 minutes about, holy floof. I just ranted, you know, my voice is dead now. That's great. But yeah, thank you all for listening. Sorry, Kingdom Key 3. Signing off. That's my two cents on Konami. What do you guys think of them? Hate them? Love them? You can't love them. There's no way you can love them. Peace out, Little Keychains, and good night.